I have it on camera. I should practice.
She can be like that because she's too weak on the right or too strong on the left. Looks like that's the case. She sits you to the right, she puts her pelvis left, but the back right, it's easier on the lumbar area. It's easier than the left. That's illogical. She's a girl.
Oh, finally got them.
But that tells you,
when you start
to figure what is there for them, you see you have no movement. There is a little bend on the lumbar vertebra, from the L4, the four lumbar, L4, L3, L2, L1, and T18. There is a little bend. Not a lot, a little bit. And the one on the left, she protected.
Could that be why she
did switch transitions? Yeah. Also why she did a mistake like that.
Yeah.
Do that once more. That's her. Because she has a pelvic, is oblique, and that automatically, you know, I'm not a fancy mover, but I'm not dead leg. Therefore, when I walk like that, I walk normally, okay? Or let me believe it. But then, if I move the pelvis like that, and I walk, now you see a shorter stride. See? Alors, dans les shorter strides, is there the pelvis is further back. Therefore, for the same swing of my legs, if my pelvic is here, the swing plus my feet here, like that. But if my pelvic is here, the swing plus my feet here, shorter. And so the kinematic abnormality you see with the handling is due to the way she is. When you pick up the canter, the two hand legs engage at the same time. One is behind the other, and you move at the same time. Therefore, the fulcrum, it's a lumbosacral articulation, right? Just here. At the trot, one leg is forward, one leg is back. Therefore, the fulcrum is the hips. But at the canter, it's here, but because she is crooked, that's difficult. And then it's due to that. So you can, and if you want to jump, that's going to make her difficult to, for example, to collect in and out Well, she will enter too long and she should flex before the second one. That's going to be difficult. If she is a friend, she will accept, eject right on the time, because that's that the way she is. So you can predict a lot of small difficulty on the over the jump. Same level on the flat. Why they do that? Because like me, they are not perfect. You are very close, but therefore they never analyze their problem. They live in the moment. Therefore they protect it. So they start with a small imbalance and they never work it. They just protect it and protect it and protect it. The problem is that the imbalance creates other problems which they protect. So they build up several layers of protection. The process is easy to understand. Imagine I walk like that and I have a nail here and I feel the nail in my foot. Immediate effect, I shift the weight to the outside. Then I resolve the problem if I live in the moment. And then I start to walk like that. After 2 weeks, my knee will hurt. Okay? But I am a horse. Therefore, I don't connect the knee with the feet. So that protect my knee. And I walk like that. Okay? And after 2 weeks later, my hips hurt. Okay? I don't connect. I protect my hips. Okay? And I have to be completely crooked for a small problem to start with. But I don't fix it. I cumulate, I build. Protection. That's what they do. They live in the moment. Therefore, they cannot understand if I change that, I will be better. But you can. So you watch that, and you say, okay, well, that is a problem. That is what you see. Where that comes from? That's a difficult question to figure. Where that start? Because you have several layers of protection. And once you can figure where that's at, then you can do a gymnastic to fix it. And you have interest to do it because you will not do it by yourself. So you have to figure how to help them. Okay? Whenever you want to do dressage or jumping, you have interest to figure where is the root cause of that. So I ask you, where she sits you. And you immediately tell me to the right, which is logical, and because she's like that. But it's logical, but not necessarily true. They can, even like that, there is two rotations possible. One this way, one this way. Therefore, even if she's like that, but rotate this way, she will sit you there. Therefore, if she sits you there, she's on the wrong rotation. The rotation, when they bend, they turn the spine, always. So as soon as they bend, they turn, as soon as they turn, they bend. That's always what it is. However, for one bend, it can be the good rotation, which is like that, or the wrong rotation, which is like that. Okay? She situates to the right. Okay? Therefore, when she bends left, the rotation is wrong. Okay? She situates on the right, and therefore she turns like that. When she bends left, she should turn this way. However, when she bends right, the rotation will be correct because she's here. Theoretically, you could cut a line. You could put a line in the middle of the horse, and the trunk is going to turn like that. Right, left, right, left, with a walk. Okay? Same as the trunk. Theoretically, she should rotate equally, right and left. In reality, she's probably here, on your right, okay? All the time. She's probably rotated like that. You look like that, that's where they start. It's nothing more than a muscle imbalance. Therefore, it can be fixed. You see? But she will not fix it herself. You have to fix it. How? That's a good question.
What should be?
I don't have no idea. But we are going to try for an idea. But you have to bear a fan. It's never one problem. It's always a leader. Therefore, you see something that might not be the root cause. The root cause is logically there, but they have their own logic. So we are going to try a few movements, going to ask you a few movements, and we are going to see how she reacts. And then according to the way she reacts, we will start to have a pretty good idea what must be that or it must be that. Okay? So you go on a circle to the right. And then whenever we are going to ask with a vertebral column, we are going to start by a longitudinal flexion. We are going to ask the horse to become one. The way you do that is by talking to her brain. You are going to adjust the movement of your vertebral column to the movement of her vertebral column. Right now you feel your back move like that. It's not a vertebral column, it's your legs that are making you move like that. If you succeed, if you absorb this movement by keeping your spine very straight, opening the chest a little bit, and from the psoas muscles which are there, straightening the three curves of your vertebral column, therefore decide to move less. Doesn't contract the shoulder, less. She reacts immediately. Okay, she slows down. She slows down because she wants to follow you. She wants to stay in harmony with you. Okay? And that's really what you want her to do, except that you don't want her to stop. So you let her slow down. That's nothing wrong with that. But you just keep the legs ready to act before she stops. And so slow her down with the back. A little bit slower. Yeah, like that. Yeah. You are right to push. Okay, yeah, you have a good feeling. You are right to push, you just push a little bit too much. Okay. So let her slow down, because to slow down, there are muscles on the back. We are in mirror image direction. And they are there to resist gravity. So when they slow down, those muscles are working. That's better. What you need to do there. She thinks, how can I slow down and push in the same time? Solution is to work with her back, but she's not sure yet how to do it. Therefore, slow her down and keep a little bit of activity here. And at one moment, she's going to feel more round. She's going to feel that the back became a little bit round. Yes. And make the circle a little bit smaller. Yeah. Right now, we just prepare her for lateral bending that we are going to ask. Okay, because longitudinal flexion, which you try to create there, is going to make the lateral bending easier. So slow her down until she feels she became wrong. Yeah. So there she plays ping pong. She goes too slow, too fast, too slow, too fast. So keep working, do it very well with your body. Slow her down. She stays somewhat active, therefore the worm became very soft, like you walk on your pillow, like she walks with the stomach up. Yes. Teeny bit slower, but active. Mm-hmm. But not too active. Yeah. But slow. But active. Yeah. You feel that? She feels like she became taller. Well, that's what you want. When you feel that, she don't really become taller. It's just the muscles of the back work together. And that's why you feel the lift. Okay? So when you feel that, then you are in good shape to ask her lateral bending and make the circle smaller. And then slow down until you feel once again this moment where she cannot lift it. Yeah. Slow but active. Active but slow. But active, but slow. You keep the both in the same time. Yeah, control, you do very well. Until you feel she starts to control your back. Yes. Yes. Yeah, like that. You feel that? Good. Then turn your pelvis to the right. You put her on a slightly smaller circle. But do not bend the spine, do not turn the shoulder more than the pelvis. Just rest right.
Because if you change the way you move your back, she's not going to be capable to keep her back up. Therefore, the way you move your spine, which you do.